adrenal gland.
This is a low far view of the parathyroid. How many parathyroid glands are there present in the human body? You have two pairs of four parathyroid glands. Where are they located? They are located on the posterior surface of the thyroid gland. Alright, and they are four in number. They are oval shaped or P-shaped bodies, and they consist of a connective tissue capsule which surrounds the gland, and this capsule sends in septas within the parenchyma of the gland. So this is a high power view of the gland. You can see this is the covering capsule and this is the parenchyma of the gland. What does the parenchyma consist of? It consists of cords, anastomosing cords of cells which are separated by means of sinusoids or capillaries. And here you can see the cells are arranged in the form of anastomosing cords or networks. And then you have the interconnective tissue, intercellular connective tissue in between these cords of cells. And then you have a lot of sinusoidal capillaries. Let me focus another gland for you. So here you can see this is the connective tissue septa, and here you can see these are the cords, anastomosing cords of the cells of the parenchyma of the parathyroid gland. We see the high power view of the gland. Right, it consists of two types of cells. Right, the main population consists of chief cells, round oval cells having a vesicular nucleus with a weakly acidophilic cytoplasm. These are known as the chief cells. Other than the chief cells, you can also come across a few darkly acidophilic cells which are known as the oxyphil cells. Oxyphil cells are much larger in size as compared to the chief cells. Alright? So the major population of the parathyroid gland consists of the chief cells which are responsible for the production of the hormone parathormone. And in between the cords of cells you can also see some amount of adipose tissue within this gland. So here what you see, these are the fat cells or the adipose tissue present in the gland. So here you can see, these are all the nuclei of the chief cells. Chief cells which produce the hormone parathormone. What is the function of parathormone? It is responsible for, what does it do? It determines the calcium levels in the blood as well as the tissue fluid. Alright, so what will happen if the parathyroid glands are removed from the body? What will be the result? Will the patient survive? Will the patient survive if the parathyroid glands are accidentally removed? No, because what will happen? Suddenly the calcium levels will go down and the patient will go into tetany, resulting in death of the patient within 1 or 2 days. Because of tetany and paralysis of the muscles. Alright, so this is a very, very important gland. Now, so here you can see this is the chief population consisting of the chief cells. Other than, we can also come across oxyphil cells. Now, the oxyphil cells are very few in number as compared to the chief cells, and these auxiphil cells are not seen in the newborn. Alright, they are present only in adults, they are not present in newborn in children. They start developing only after puberty, the auxiphil cells. So you can just hardly come across any few of the auxiphil cells. All what we see here, these are the chief cells which produce the parathormone. And the auxiphil cells are seen only in human, some monkeys and ox. No other animals show the presence of these cells, auxiphil cells, okay? So not present in the children, they start appearing only after puberty. What we see all over here, these are the chief cells seen in this slide. And then you will come across lot of capillaries and sinusoids and adipose tissue in the substance of this gland. You can start seeing your slides if you've got the slide boxes today. We just have 3 slides to show today. Thank you.